In this Q&A video, we're going to answer the question, what should the IP rating for a consumer unit be? This question relates to the video that Gary made of an on-site, real-life installation of the PremShield consumer unit from PremSpec. So please go and check that out if you haven't already seen it. But coming back to the question for this video, it's an important one to answer because when we install a consumer unit, we tend to knock a load of holes in it to bring our cables through. Quite naturally, we need to do that. However, this may have the unwanted side effect of accidentally contravening the required IP rating for a consumer unit. And there's actually different requirements for IP ratings depending on which bit of the consumer unit you're considering. Let's look at the official guidance in BS7671. The relevant regulation is 416.2.1, which reads, live parts shall be inside enclosures or behind barriers, providing at least the degree of protection IPXXB or IP2X. There's some exceptions to this rule, but we won't worry too much about that now. Let's just think about what IP2X or IPXXB means. IP2X means that the enclosure, in this case a consumer unit, must have protection against entry of objects greater than 12 millimeters, which may seem like a random number until we compare it with the meaning of IPXXB, which means protection against the entry of fingers, of which 12 millimeters is a fairly typical diameter. So this makes sense. It's very reasonable that we need to prevent people from sticking their fingers into electrical enclosures and getting a shock. However, there's still a little more information here, as certain areas of the consumer unit require a higher level of protection, as we read in the next regulation, 416.2.2. A horizontal top surface of a barrier or enclosure which is readily accessible shall provide a degree of protection of at least IPXXD or IP4X. So what does this mean? Well, IP4X means the enclosure must prevent access with objects larger than 1 millimeter in diameter, and IPXXD means you can't get wires in there. So this may at first glance seem like a fairly simple regulation to meet, but remember that if you remove a 20 mil knockout and put in a grommet, you may leave enough of a gap in the enclosure to violate this regulation and create a dangerous, or at the very least, non-compliant situation. So if you're bringing cables into the top surface, it may be worth using closed grommets, or better still, individual stuffing glands with the correct shape insert instead. So there we go. The top surface of a consumer unit must have an IP rating of at least IPXXD or IP4X, and all the remaining sides must be IP rated at IPXXB or IP2X. As always, we'd like to hear from you on this issue. Do you always check your IP ratings on a finished consumer unit? Do you have any top tips for how to maintain those ratings during an installation? Please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. And as always, thank you very much for watching.